All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to some more Farming Simulator 2015. It's Pixie and me again. We are still down our third farmhand. I think he's taking an extended vacation.
I think so too. I think he needs to get his butt back to work. Slacker.
So at any rate, which actually I'm quite surprised. I've dumped almost, I think, 10 hours into this game now already. It's crazy on how much I'm doing it. But a lot of it, unfortunately for you guys, is kind of like outside of recording, but it's just a lot of prep work.
Yeah, it is.
Like right now, we haven't purchased anything, but we have been, Pixie and I have been running over to the store. And like right now, for example, wood chips is really high. It's almost 3,000 a ton for another 15 hours. We have been running canola. Oh my gosh, canola is almost $2,500 a ton right now.
Yeah.
And we literally, as you guys can see, my bank account information, $237,000. We literally ran canola to the diner like madmen, back and forth, back and forth. And I think, Pixie, you've got just as much cash as I do.
Yep.
Between the both of us. And we actually have a field of canola waiting right now. But unfortunately, it was just pouring down rain. And we've got workers sitting here waiting to harvest canola. But unfortunately, this will be our first canola harvest. It's just we've had a whole silo. Oh, there we go. The harvester just started.
It's about time, you slacker. Jeez.
Yeah, well, it's because of the rain. Now that the storm has passed, they can start harvesting canola now.
Okay.
All right. Well, that kind of backfired because I was going to try and... What we were going to do is to do the forestry stuff. We're going to finish up testing and attempting forestry equipment and while these guys do their thing. So, but let's go ahead and... we'll focus on forestry, and we'll kind of check on these guys from time to time.
Okay.
All right, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to head over to the truck, because I've actually got the truck parked over there right now.
Okay.
You can actually come on over to the truck if you want.
Let's see here.
I don't know what the heck happened over here, but... Do you see where the truck is?
Yes.
All right, go ahead and jump in it. There you go. Perfect. All right. So in order for us to operate this equipment, we need a piece of equipment that's powerful enough to operate the wood chipper and whatnot. And we have enough to purchase the tractor for it. Oh, gosh. You got your chainsaw out.
Yeah. I have to.
Well, come on over here, Tixie. Another thing we need to do is we probably need to go get the semi-trailer and bring that over here, because people were saying that we can use the wood chipper. And we can just bring logs right to the lumber yard itself.
Mm.
I think the biogas plant is where we turn in the wood chips.
Well, then why don't I go back to the farm and I'll bring over one of our tractors and trailer.
Yeah, the semi-trailer I parked in the barn. In the meantime, I'm going to purchase our new tractor so we can operate the wood chipper.
Mm, okay.
I think it was the Lamborghini. Is the one that we needed to buy.
Was it the Lamborghini or the Bugatti?
The Bugatti. There's not a Bugatti.
Mm-hmm.
We've got a Lamborghini, which is the Mach 230 VRT, which was $195,000.
Mm-hmm.
Which has 162 kilowatts of power and 220 horsepower. And then we have the next one, which is $229,000, which I barely have enough for, which is the Dude's Far. It's the 7250 TTV. It's got 193 kilowatts of power and 263 horsepower.
Let's go with that one.
All right, that one it is. All right, purchased it.
Okay, where is it? I don't see it here.
It's sitting at the dealership. I have it here.
Of course you do. I wanted it.
I bet you did. I'm using it for the wood chipper.
I know, but I was gonna bring the trailer over there with it. Doesn't that make more sense?
Oh, I see. Well, we do need another tractor anyway. Well, let's take a look at the forestry equipment really quick before we make another purchase on a tractor.
Okay.
Forestry. Oops. I'm glad I almost didn't just buy that. Actually, I didn't have enough money to buy it anyway. How much money do you have?
I have $236,000.
Ooh, we're really close to purchasing the Scorpion King. I wonder if I should have just bought that. Because you can purchase the Pons or the Ponzi Buffalo.
Mm-hmm.
Or, ooh, I don't know. How much did you say you have again?
I have 236,000.
236,000. We are really close to being able just to purchase right to the Scorpion King.
Oh, dang it.
If I wouldn't have bought this tractor, we would have been able to.
Well, then why didn't you just do that?
Here, why don't I sell the rest of our forest, like the wood chipper and stuff? Because I think this forester equipment, I think it's got like its own... Oh, it says this machine can cut down trees. That's what it is. It's just a tree cutter, which we have the chainsaw for that. So I think we're actually good. Okay, let's try and see what we've got first. But
okay. Well, don't I say just let's just go roll with what we have first.
Yeah.
Because, I mean, we've got a bunch of tractors and stuff, so.
Yeah. I'm trying to get, like, there's a bunch of trees. It's almost like the windstorm or something knocked all of our equipment around over here.
I don't think it did. I think you're just a sloppy lumberjack. And left everything everywhere.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so now that we've got this under control, I'm going to bring this right over here.
Just for the record,
uh-huh.
We might want to use that big trailer that or big tractor that we just bought.
Yeah.
To tow these loads with the logs and everything, because this little tractor was barely capable of getting it up that hill.
Just the empty trailer?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. When you turn on the wood chipper, by the way, your tractor revs up. Like, my tractor is revving up, like, right now.
Well, should I have brought over that empty...
The semi-trailer? Or what?
Isn't this the semi-trailer?
Yep, that's it. So now what you can do,
mm-hmm.
is we can pick up the big logs and put them in that thing.
How do we pick up the logs?
With this like type this little look arm looking thing that I've got here.
Oh, well then pick them up and put them in my tractor.
There's
or on my trailer.
Well, I've got these guys here. I'm trying to I'm going to try and like put these in the wood chipper and see. You see this pipe right here,
mm-hmm.
that I just extended out? We're going to need to get an actual container, you know, like one of the trailers.
That's what I was talking about. That's why I said maybe I should have brought that over here instead of this one. You told me to bring this one over here.
Yeah, no, that's good. Like, drop that off. That way we have that here.
Oh, all right.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
That way whenever we want to bring the logs and stuff in.
All right.
You understand?
Yep, I got you now. I'm following.
Okay.
I'm picking up what you're laying down.
Good looking out.
All right, so let me go back and get the other one. Well, don't start wood chipping stuff till I get my trailer here. Oh, man, I just ran into a stump.
I'm trying to figure this equipment out first.
Excuse me, pardon me, logs. Go back and get my trailer.
This is, like, kind of difficult to do anyway.
Making me run all over God's creation here.
Sorry.
Sorry, I'm gonna go four-wheeling. Woohoo! Caught some air.
Jeez.
Woohoo! Oh, God. Oh, God. Whew! Am I lucky I landed back on my tires? I was upside down for a second there. Note to self. No more four-wheeling.
No more four-wheeling, Tixie.
Okay. That was close. That was really close, Barry G. Host.
Okay. I can't get this thing to, like, let go of my log here.
I think we need instruction manuals for all of our equipment.
All right. Well, it's in the wood chipper. Nothing's happening to it, though. Maybe I gotta chop that little bit of a branch off of it or something. Maybe. I don't know. We'll see.
All right, I'm on my way back.
Okay. I'm gonna come back in and I'm gonna get this thing started up again. Oops. Alright, so the wood chipper is going, but it's not, like, doing anything.
Maybe it's because,
there's nothing there to catch the...
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it could be. Alright, well, I'm gonna work on getting another piece of the wood, because this thing is kind of a pain in the butt. I don't like the... I mean, the forestry is a really cool idea, but mm-hmm. you gotta have a lot of patience with, picking this stuff up. You know what I mean?
Yeah, can you hire somebody?
No.
Is there migrant workers for forestry?
I doubt it. I seriously doubt that. See, it's not doing anything. As far as the wood chippings go, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And are you perfectly parked, like, right over it?
I think so. Let me try backing up.
All right, I've got another piece. Maybe I need to push it in there. Okay, I'm going to come over this way. I'm going to twist the little thing over.
I just see logs in there. They're just, like, bouncing off the thing.
So I'm, like, pushing it in there.
Great, you're gonna break our equipment.
This equipment, or this, I hear your chainsaw, by the way.
I know, I'm seeing if maybe we need to have smaller pieces.
You think so? Do you think we really would need smaller pieces?
Oh, is it going in now?
It doesn't look like it.
Hmm.
Yeah, so what I'm wondering is if... Because I know that on the other, like the forestry equipment, the last thing that you can buy is the Scorpion King. Like this one here, this one is just to transport logs, which is kind of what we've got already. And then the last one is the this machine can cut down trees, is what it says. But it's like I don't really kind of see the sense in using that to cut down trees, you know what I mean?
Well, maybe it cuts down the trees and then...
I just jammed up our thing, though.
And maybe it automatically puts it in the wood chipper.
Yeah. I mean, the wood chipper, it's not unless we have to use smaller pieces or something, but this is, like, more hassle than what it is worth, you
mm-hmm.
know? So I'm wondering if maybe we shouldn't just get the semi-trailer... And,
loaded up with logs.
Loaded up with logs, and we'll try that. So, did you already cut down some trees?
I cut down one tree.
All right, I'm going to go park this thing over here real quick.
Okay.
Because this thing's being a pain in the butt.
Yeah.
All right, so we're going to park that there. We're going to drop that off. Now that I've got... So, what you need to do is get that smaller trailer... You know, the smaller tractor
mm-hmm.
that you left in the middle of the road that I crashed into. And then we're going to use that one to load up logs. Are you cutting down trees again?
Yeah, trying okay. to at least.
All right, so here's the semi-trailer. Okay, now I'm going to come over here, and I'm going to get this tractor, and I'm going to try and, gosh, our crops are probably sitting over there waiting to be offloaded, too.
Great. Do you want me to go take care of that?
I see trees falling over there. Alright, I'm coming over there now to see if we can't pick these logs up. Because if we can't figure this out, or if we can't get this, I'm about to,
Hey. You just ruined my cut.
Sorry.
Dang it. Now I'm stuck in here. Oh, wait. Okay, I got out.
Alright, I'm folding the feet. Alright, I'm extending the arm now to try and pick this thing up here. Can you actually see when I'm doing all this?
Give me just a second, I'll let you know. Alright, let me see you.
Whoa.
Is it cutting down the tree?
No, there's so many branches in the way of it.
Let me see if I can't cut some more off. Excuse me, move your arm, please. Thank you.
There we go. Okay, let's try that now. Okay, can you cut the one underneath the clasp there?
This one right here?
I don't know what... Yeah, that one. Try and cut that one off. If you can. If not, it's not a big deal.
Let me try changing my angle. Nope.
All right, watch out. I'll just try and grab it.
I can cut this one. Let me try getting underneath it, see if that makes a difference.
All right, I think I might have the actual... Whoa!
Whoa. you're a little...
This thing is too... Oh, God. I can't pick the tree up.
Oh, God. You're going to tip over.
Yeah.
You're going to die. Let go. Let go.
I can't let it go. Okay. Get out of there. I'm going to kill you. Whoa. Okay. Okay, this thing is not strong enough to pick up that whole log, so we're going to have to... Can you cut it in half?
I'm trying right now.
There we go. Let me try this piece here. Great. Now I can't even reach it now. Yeah, this forestry stuff, like I said, it's kind of a cool idea, but it's so time consuming.
And yeah, it is.
And for the money for it?
It's pretty hard.
It is kind of hard.
All right, that should have done it for you. Let me see if I can't. Oh. No, that's just cutting that log. Or that stump, I should say.
All right, I'm back out now. All right. Let's try and at least get one log over there. I can't figure... We can always try and... You want to get the big tractor, maybe bring that wood chipper back over here, and I'll try putting maybe one of these small branches in it?
Yeah, I can do that.
It's sitting over there if you want to just unhitch the big tractor from the semi.
All right, hold on.
We'll try that and see how that works. Oh God, I'm gonna tip over. I can't even pick up this small trunk either. Oh God, I'm dead.
Oh, this is a nice tractor.
Oh gosh.
Oh wow, that was really fast.
Yeah, about this one. I can't even grab these other trunks. They're way too heavy for this little tractor piece.
Are they really?
Yeah. So bring the chipper over here. I'm going to try at least putting in a small log. I want to at least see something get shredded after right. I just wasted a bunch of our money.
Okay, you should know by now I'm not very good at this backing up situation. Ugh. Can't seem to get the angle right.
It's all right. I want to at least see something shredded. That's all I care about. All right, I got a small stick, Tixie.
All right.
I got a small stick. You need to put the... Whoa, what are you doing?
I have trouble driving.
You need to put the shredder side of it on my driver's side. So pull forward. And then you're going to turn... I'll tell you when to turn left. Keep going.
Okay.
And turn left and get on this side of me. There you go. Okay, now... Do you see where the little metal hatch comes out? That's where the shredder is. You need to get a little bit further. Keep going. You're driving on the logs is why. All right, here, do me a favor and just open it up like that.
Okay, hold on. So, fold out support feet.
Let me take off these support feet really quick. Okay, we got that. Let me try and move my tractor forward before you do that. Oh my gosh, my guy keeps getting inside the... Oh, don't drop the log. Okay, yeah, go ahead and do your support feet.
Okay.
You still got the logs in there, too. Oh, they're sliding out.
That's fine.
All right. The problem is we need to feed it from that side. So we actually need it to be flipped around. I had it the wrong way. I forgot the feed side was over there. We also need to get that other log out of there too, but there you go. Go ahead and flip her around. You're going to have to back it in there.
I am not backing it in there.
You can do it.
I cannot.
Oh, oh, you just lost that other log, which is good.
That's what I was trying to do.
All right, perfect. We'll drive around this side of me now. I just want to shred one log, and then I'm done with forestry.
Okay.
That's all I want. One log. There you go. Okay, go ahead and fold it out now. That's all I want in my life, is to shred one log. Okay, now you're going to hit B to turn it on.
Okay.
See how it revs the tractor up?
Yeah.
Uh-oh. It just took it out. Oh, it's
in
there.
No, it fell back in there.
It's in there.
There's got to be something that we're missing. Like, we've got to be overcomplicating it or something. I don't know.
I have no idea either. Because it can't be this hard. See, I'm pushing it in there.
Yeah.
It's just, it's not, like, shredding. Try hitting O.
Okay.
I was just going to see if maybe it would start working with the pipe out, but... All right. I've officially had it with forestry equipment.
Me too.
And the amount of time it takes us to... All right, let's just detach the equipment.
Uh-huh. And leave the forestry equipment here.
We'll leave the forestry equipment here for now. Oh. Go ahead and grab that trailer since you drive faster. And I'll meet you over at the fields.
All right.
Forestry equipment's pretty cool. I think if you have a lot more time, you know, to tinker with it. I think that in all seriousness, though, even though we are complete, like, amateurs at forestry equipment, I really think in the amount of time it takes to cut the things down, get them in your tractor, get them loaded up, drive them, you could have ran a field of canola for $150,000 in the time it takes you to do logs.
Right, I agree.
So I think we're going to stick with that. I mean, it was cool. I wanted to try out forestry, but in all honesty, it's just not really worth the time it takes.
Not unless we're doing something wrong, and then, you know, if we're doing something wrong and you guys have some tips for us, you know, feel free to leave those comments down below so that way we can try and figure this out. Otherwise, we're done with forestry.
Yeah, our tractor, our harvesters are full. So I'm going to go.
Oh my God, this tractor is amazing. I'm going 60 miles per hour.
Are you really?
Yeah.
Yeah, those high-end tractors are nice. I mean, we still have a lot of other stuff we can do other than
for. You keep your grubby hands off my new tractor. Do you understand me?
All right.
Well, don't you touch my tractor, Barry G-Host.
Okay, I promise I won't. So in the meantime, and we've got other harvesters that we can purchase, and we can also start getting into, like we've got corn, we've got other larger harvesters. Like the bigger the harvesters, the longer the headers you can buy, which gets more of your fields done.
Mm.
You see how small our harvesters are? You know, the blades in front?
Yeah.
If you get the bigger harvesters, they do like 4 times the size of that.
Oh, wow.
Are you
off? Crazy.
Yeah, it is crazy. Are you offloading that guy up there?
Yeah.
Okay. So anyway, yeah, so this is canola. Canola currently, I think, is selling for... look at that, $2,500, okay? Now, the only reason wood chips right now is as high as it is, because it's for 13 more hours. It's going for $2,900 at the bio plant, all right? You know what, babe? I was just thinking about it. Don't we have wood chips in our silos?
We do.
We have 16,218 tons of wood chips.
Uh-huh.
So we can actually sell that, but I don't know how to get it out of there.
I don't know.
Not unless you have to have a front end loader to scoop up the wood chips or something like that.
Because there was no,
there's no conveyor for it.
Right. There was no conveyor belt for it. So
see, there's our wood chips. There's our beets and those are our potatoes. So we have a little bit of beets and potatoes here, but
those aren't going for very much right now, are they?
Beets and potatoes?
Yeah, I don't think they are.
Potatoes are $8.99 and sugar beets are $9.77. Right now the big ones are canola. Canola is almost $2,500 for that, and that's exactly what we just planted.
Mm-hmm.
That's why we've made so much money right now. So in all honesty, how much money do you have left?
I have $236,000
still. $236,000. So in essence, you can probably purchase like a Case Agriculture Axial Flow 7130 harvester. This one's a 7130. Let me see what how much the header is for it.
Should we maybe do a front end loader or start doing like baling technology or?
Well, the baling technology is kind of cool, but you can only do wheat.
Mm.
And with that, we have to get a windrower starting at $17,000 or $32,000 for a medium-sized one. So you're looking at $32,000 for that. And then we would need, after you get a windrower, we would need a baling machine, which starts at $88,000. And after you get a baling machine, then you need to put it onto a trailer.
Okay.
Which is $45,000. So I don't think we have... Do we have enough to do that? Well, let's see. We would need... Here's a baler, which is $88,000. So okay. $88,000 plus $45,000. So you're looking at 80, 90, 100, 125. So we'll say $130,000 for those two. And then a windrower, $32,000. So we could do it. Like after we do canola, we can purchase those three if you want to do that and start doing some baling technology stuff. As far as where we take it, though, I'm not sure where we take the hay bales, though.
Hey, what about buying like a universal bucket for the front loader?
A universal bucket for the front loader?
Yeah, go to the front loader category.
Uh-huh.
I think that's where I went. Yeah, front loaders. And then scroll 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, I think, times.
Front loader? That's wheel loader. I'm trying to see where you see front loaders at.
Go back right there on that front page.
Uh-huh.
Far left. Third one down.
Front loaders, okay. And then the universal bucket.
Mm-hmm. It's like click over 7 pages.
Yeah, it's $900.
Uh-huh.
Well, you would need a front loader.
That's
just the bucket.
Oh, well, where's the front loader?
You got to go down to wheel loaders. the very bottom. It's $165,000 just for the tractor.
What?
And then you got to get a bucket attachment or see. Look, there's the unit. There's the universal bucket for $3,400.
That's can't for, I just attach a bucket to my to my tractor?
Not that. Oh, and see, that's another thing too. We have sewing machine, like larger sewing machines, to get the productivity up higher. But see, when you start getting into these bigger machines, you need bigger equipment to pull, like these plows.
Mm-hmm.
Oh my gosh! Like, they do insane amounts of terrain, but they're insanely heavy. And you need high-end equipment to run that sort of... I mean, we can start baling technology.
Okay, well, whatever you want to do, honey. In all honesty, at this point, I'm so confused.
It's not that bad. So what we'll do... Oh, the beacons are on the harvesters, by the way.
Oh, okay. I'm on my way.
All right, so we need to offload these guys. So forestry, I think, is going to be scratched out of this. It's not that big of a moneymaker. I think I'll probably just park that equipment just because.
Mm-hmm. Well, until we can maybe figure it out or have more time to figure it out.
Yeah, because as of now, forestry is, like I said, it's cool, but it's not worth the time it takes to sell it when, heck, we could be making serious money on canola right now. You know what I mean?
Exactly. Until canola drops. But I guess that's just kind of goes for everything.
Yeah. All right, I got a full load of canola, so I'm just going to go drop it in the silo. Unless you're... Well, you've got that load up there, too. Is it still going to the diner?
Let me check.
Because if it is, you're right up there, aren't you?
I think last time the restaurant wanted wheat. I don't think it wanted canola anymore.
But somebody was also saying that we can take the canola to the flour mill, right? We don't have to drive it all the way to the... No, because the restaurant is flashing right now.
Yeah, because it wanted wheat, remember?
Oh, is that what it is?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, I said canola at the beginning. I meant to say wheat. We were selling off the rest of our wheat.
Right, and I didn't correct you because I thought, okay, well, maybe he knows, maybe he was selling canola when I wasn't with him or something, so I didn't correct.
No, you're right. We're actually selling wheat. That's how we got the money we got, not canola.
Right.
So scratch that. That's exactly what happened. All right, so yeah, we were selling wheat off. There was a sale. Like right now, wheat is worth junk right now. So canola.
But the restaurant was in desperate need of it, so they were giving us like, I don't even remember how much it was. It was crazy. It was more than the canola, I think.
It was, and it was green, and it was for like 15 hours or 24 hours. So I slowed time down, and me and her just wrecked it up on selling that. So let's go take this into the restaurant, or to the flour mill then.
The canola?
Yeah.
Okay.
And then after this round of harvesting back here, maybe we'll do wheat, and then the next video... we'll do our baling technology stuff then, since the forestry was kind of a bust.
Yeah, it was.
I mean, you got a good tractor out of it.
Yeah.
That tractor you've got is a really nice tractor, which is gonna pull things. Like if we now you know what you could do? You could probably even buy a bigger. So look how much faster you're going than me.
Oh yeah, I freaking love this thing.
See, now you could probably get rid of that trailer, babe. You should probably buy yourself a new trailer and get one of those bigger tippers.
Maybe, yeah. That way I can carry bigger loads. And since I'm the one that carries most of the loads anyways.
Yeah, you should get yourself a pink big tipper.
Oh, can I get a pink one?
Yeah. I think you can. You might be able to. Here.
You better not get me all excited and get my hopes up and then not be able to come through on this one.
All right, so after you dump this, let's see. Look at that money already.
Oh, yeah.
I just jumped up to almost 30 grand for that load.
Oh, yeah.
All right, so let's stop here for a second.
Okay.
All right, so now you're going to want to reset your tractor and your trailer. So I'm going to leave out of here so that way you can see your stuff.
Okay. Let me see if I can remember how to do this. Okay. Oh, I didn't mean... Dang it.
Oh, gosh.
Hold on a second.
You're killing me, Tixie.
Okay, there's my reset.
You're going to want to reset the tractor and the trailer.
Yes, okay. And then we're going to do that trailer. Okay. And then
you're going to go to the store.
Okay. Then I'm going to go to the store.
Uh-huh.
And go to Tippers.
Yep. Okay. Now make sure you don't buy a tractor trailer one. Like, you want to get like a big one that's just like a side dump style. Just like the one we currently have.
How do I know what the difference is?
Well, click on them and look at the description. What do the descriptions tell you?
Tippers/trailers are used to transport the harvest.
All right, so let's see. Let's look at tippers. See how they all have a little hitch?
Yeah.
That's good. The ones that have like a fifth wheel plate, like the very last one, the cramp.
Yeah.
That's 98,000. That doesn't have. That's a fifth wheel. That's like an actual semi. Everything before that, you can get.
Okay.
So I mean, now it's
so just probably just go with this. I'm thinking maybe because we have the Brantner.
We have the Brantner. We have like two of those right now.
I'm thinking maybe go with this.
Flegel. Okay, so.
Or the cramp, that's next to it.
All right. So
which one?
Whichever one you want to do.
Okay, so the Flegel has a capacity of 32,000.
Yep, and the next one's 40,000.
40,000.
So go with the cramp then.
Okay.
So you should be able to click buy.
Okay, click buy.
Oh yeah, so that one didn't allow you to choose a color. Whereas like the low end one allows you to choose the color of the trailer.
I'm done with you. So I have to go to the store and pick this up now?
Either that or I can just reset it for you.
Oh, well, reset it for me. What are you waiting for?
There you go. It should be sitting next to you now. Holy cow.
Oh, that is beautiful.
That thing is massive. Look at this. Look at the size difference in the trailers. Are you going to even be able to tow that thing?
I don't know. I need to kind of...
Yeah. Oh my gosh, get out of the tractor.
Can you hitch me up, please? Don't touch my tractor. You better give it back.
You're killing me, Tixie.
I told you I suck at... Oh my god, you about killed the tractor.
There you go. Now go, go relieve our harvesters over there.
Oh, okay.
Actually, I'll relieve those guys in this. Actually, you know what? How much do we have canola in there you can offload?
Let's see.
Because that's what's selling for a lot right now.
Nope. Silo's empty. Let's go get our...
Jeez. You just...
Get out of my way. Oh, God. Seriously? Go.
Would you go already? You're killing me. With your big old your trailer is cramping my style. Did you see what I did there?
Uh-huh. you're just jelly.
Look how much faster you're pulling with me than me, and you have a bigger trailer.
I thought for sure it was gonna bog me down, but not really. Can I fit under this thing?
Oh, I didn't even think about
it. I can't fit under them.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
So you know what we're going to have to do with that trailer then? Let me see. Go under. Are you serious?
I whacked the arm.
All right. You know what we're going to have to do then is we're going to have to use these guys and then take it to the silo and then fill your tractor and trailer up for doing the big dump runs.
For like, okay.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
How much money do you still have though?
$212,000.
Okay. Do we have enough to buy another tractor like that then?
I think
we do. Actually, we were going to save that and we were going to do the baling technology.
Okay, so we'll save that. Is the restaurant still collecting wheat? Because maybe I can take a thing of, or a load over to the wheat plant, or to the restaurant with wheat.
No, I don't see any.
I think it is.
Is it?
Yeah. So let me do a, let me run some wheat over there real quick.
Okay. Yeah, because then we can, well, the thing is, in all honesty, the baling technology is like, I'm not sure where to take that. Like in 2013, you would just kind of drop it off like at this barn and then you would just get paid money for it.
Right.
I got to relieve these harvesters. The harvesters are already almost done. It's crazy how fast they are. I'm going to get the plows going now. That way we can get these going.
I wonder if I'm like...
If you're what?
If I just emptied out our silo of our... Or almost emptied out our silo of wheat.
For what?
When I... With this big old thing of wheat I just took out of there.
I would. Why not?
No, I'm wondering if it was... If the capacity was there.
Oh, I see what you're saying.
Oh, I'm bogging down big time now.
Are you?
Uh-huh.
I see you. Where are you taking that?
To the restaurant. Do you never listen to anything I tell you?
What'd you say?
I'm done with you.
I got you. Well, in that case, I'm just going to run these to the silos.
Okay.
And then I'm going to let you do the big runs. So, all right. Well, I guess we'll wrap that up here. And when we come back, hopefully after a few of these runs. Actually, I'm curious before I wrap it up. I want to see how much you get for that big load.
Okay.
Before we do that. I'm very curious to see how much you get.
Okay.
I'm dropping off the canola in the silo now. Alright, so that's dropped off. I gotta grab some fuel too.
This tractor's a little bit harder to control. Just because it is so much faster.
Yeah.
That if you like turn too much, because you know how sometimes you can kind of turn too much.
Yeah.
You can get squirrely really easy on the with this one.
I'm just backing the trailer into the wood chips to see if it'll just maybe say like load, but it doesn't. I think we got to get a loader and load it in there if we want to do wood chips. See, that's another thing. How much money that's going to be.
Yeah.
And buying a loader and all that other stuff, it's like really not even worth it.
Okay, transfer me all your money so we can see how much this gives us.
All right, transfer. There's all my money.
Okay, you ready?
Yep.
Well, maybe I need to... Why is it not giving me the option to drop this off? Maybe I have to be... Oh, there we go. Okay. I had to be like fully on it, so I had to like... My tractor actually had to be off the grate.
Oh, gotcha. Are you still dumping?
Yeah.
Holy cow.
It just finished.
I have $36,000 alone.
Sweet.
And how much are you up to?
277.
Wow. 277,000. So we're already back over $300,000 again. So, all right, guys. Well, we're going to wrap this up here. You guys are now seeing how easy it is to make money in this game. I think that we're going to make some pretty good progression on our next video. Unfortunately, forestry was a bust.
That's all right.
But we've got a lot of other cool things. Like I said, we've got some baling technology that we can show you guys. We probably will purchase a windrower.
I think this tractor and this... this trailer was like the best purchase yet.
Yeah, because beet harvesting is going to be later. I mean, if we want to do beet harvesting, it's $479,000 just for that one tractor.
Mm,
but right now, but beets just aren't selling for that much to really make it worth it. So I think our biggest thing is maybe we should start really just buying the equipment for what's what's hot right now. Because even if we wanted to do potatoes, it's $479,000 for potatoes.
Jeez.
Yeah, it gets pretty expensive, but it's pretty fun. So
Okay.
But at any rate, guys, hope you guys enjoyed another farming simulator. Don't forget to buy more chickens. We'll see you guys next time.
Bye.